Evening, folks. This is Best in Slot, and welcome back to our continued Hippo Harbor build. In today's video, we're going to do lots of stuff. First things first, though, is expanding the river so it goes underneath the mountain. As it turns out, the boat actually blocks the hippos, and they started to complain about a lack of water, so I've extended that around. It was also pointed out to me via a friend on Discord that the boat tour, just like the cable car thingamajiggy, also needs to be a complete circuit, so that would be a little bit difficult with our current setup. So here I'm just moving the boundaries again so the hippos can go underwater and into this little cave section. We will be integrating that cave on the right with the actual exhibit at some point as well later on in this video. And now the rocks are in the bloody way as well, but in a second we'll get there. That little rock is... the hippos are chunky, they need a lot of room. There you go, hippos are happy, happy hippos. So in today's video, we're going to do basically the mountain design stuff, and this is going to be one of the most contentious parts of this. I want the top part of this to be moderately modern. It ends up going in a different direction. I'm going to maybe change it again, but I wanted it to feel a little bit separate from everything else. So I thought, okay, what we'll do is we'll coat it in like a more modern material, just the top bit. Like, it's like a three-tier mountain almost, the bottom two tiers, it's like a cake, right? And the bottom two tiers are carrot cake. It's nice, but it's a bit rough and ready. Is a carrot cake a rough and ready cake? I don't know, what's a rough and ready cake? Like a Victoria sponge, it's pretty simple, it's not that posh, even though it sounds posh. Right? That's the bottom two tiers, and the top tier is like fancy, it's like an opera cake, which doesn't make sense, but just roll with me on this one. It's the only metaphor I know. So I wanted it to stick out and look a little bit more man-made and controlled. So I thought we're going to coat it in these sort of man-made materials. And I've changed that, you'll see throughout the video, I've changed the colour on it about 5,000 times. I cannot for the life of me decide what colour this material should be. Part of me quite likes the darker colours because they blend really well in with the mountain. But then we've kind of coated this in like this snaking trail of rocks later on, and therefore I kind of want it light so it kind of contrasts. I'm definitely going to need some thoughts and opinions on that, but wait till you see it later on in the video before making your mind up. So that's what we're going to do at the start. We do have a fairly long time lapse study. This is only times 5 speed. I've decided I'm going to set that as my maximum speed. It might mean slightly longer time lapses, but really any faster and it's kind of hard to see what's going on. Right now I think it's quite easy to track what's happening. You know, I'm pointing down layers and layers of these columny blocky thingamajiggies. It's quite easy to see what's happening and I can explain it. Any faster, problems start to occur. So that's going to be my new maximum speed. Maximum power. Is that crisis? That's crisis. Anyways, so just... it's like icing a cake, it really is. Like, I don't want to keep coming back to this cake metaphor, but that is what it looks like. I'm draping fondant about a cake. It's very exciting. Just going to cover all that side. A lot of today is spent on the mountain, trying to make the mountain more interesting to look at, putting a lot of rocks in, putting a lot of rocks in, so many rocks. This is one of those projects that I had the idea and I was going to do the idea no matter what. And then I started to do it, and I'm about 8 hours into this build now for this one enclosure, and I'm just thinking, you know what, it's turning out pretty cool. It's still not done, but I tell you what, it's taking some hard work. It's taking a lot of hours. As I say, it isn't quite finished, so I think what we're going to do is actually live stream the end of it. It's very nearly there. I don't want to do like a part 3 because I don't think it warrants it. So I think maybe in a couple days or something, I'll hop on YouTube. We'll do a live stream right here on YouTube and we'll just kind of finish off the rest of the enclosure. You guys will be able to join in and give suggestions live. So keep an eye out for that on Thursday or Wednesday or Friday, sometime later on in the week anyway. And then we'll finally be done. But yeah, I mean, it looks cool. We're going to obviously make it blend in a lot better. I'm going to put rocks going around the top of this, and then they're going to blend in, not like that, because that looks stupid. I'm going to change that in a minute. There we go. I've seen some people stack their rocks like that, and it looks okay, and it looks very sort of artificial, but that's really not the way I'm going in for this park in general. I've seen some incredible builds on YouTube lately, and everyone's parks are so controlled, whereas mine feel very, very messy, and that's okay, that's my building style, but it means I'm going to lean into it effectively. Anyways, lots of rocks. You're going to have to get used to the rocks. There's a lot of rocks. Lots of rocks, lots of foliage, lots of pathwork. But mainly lots of rocks. It's a massive mountain. I'm going to do something much more low-key for the next exhibit. I do want something that feels a little bit more like a zoo. I'm thinking like a little sunken enclosure in between two paths that you just sort of walk around. I'm going to lay out probably the rest of the river as well. Anyways, it was really hard to get that gap. I see the gap there between the earth and the what will eventually be a path. The earth and the white border, though, is very... It's got this wee little gap in, so I'm going to cover that, the outside of that, in some more of the same texture, the same material, which is the Planet Zoo Primitive Square. And hopefully that gives it, like, it looks a little bit more real. You know, it looks like it's an actual thing rather than icing, essentially, is what I'm gonna go with. So we're going to layer these over the top, and we will be colouring them later on as well at some point. What else are we going to do? We're going to make a custom fence. We're going to get to work on the inside of the dome thing. That still needs a little bit more work, but it's definitely getting there. Again, you'll see that later on in the video, but we'll, that's the kind of thing we'll finish off in our live stream. I'd like to do this a little more often, live streaming some Planet Zoo. It's a game that really suits it because it's a game that really thrives off like inspiration and ideas and stuff like that. And for some of today, I really hadn't, but I started to really struggle about halfway through. So having like outside perspectives live and whilst I'm building would have been really helpful. The girlfriend was asleep, so, you know, what am I gonna do? I don't have any friends. Anyways, I'm joking. I have one friend. got two. Right, anyways, so let's stop being depressing and let's go ahead and stack on some of that. We're going to cover that right hand side. Basically, wherever there's a gap, we're going to put some rocks in to sum up. Now, this side of the park was actually not meant to be that rocky, but given the scale of what I've built here, I don't really see an alternative. Had to change my music there, obviously. I just don't really see an alternative way of building it without going hard on the rocks. It's really the only way that made sense to me, so... But there you go, that's a pretty good idea for what it's going to look like. And here comes the colour experimentation. First of all, okay, maybe like an eggshell white. And if we go for the white, that's what we're going to go for. Still not ready for your opinions. Hold on to it, because we're going to be putting a lot more stuff in. We're going to put some foliage in. We're going to have some fences and some paths in there and stuff like that. So wait until you see the whole thing to get a feel for it. But I do like the eggshell white. It's either going to be an eggshell white or a dark, fairly unsaturated brown sort of colour. But really, folks, God only knows. Anyway, it's more rocks. Remember, this is going to be... That bit there is actually the edge of the... people are going to be able to walk down from the top onto this lower ridge, and that's going to take them just a little bit closer to the hippos, essentially. So I'm going to redo that path because it was a bit of a mess, and just... We're going to use some angles and stuff. We do want this to be fairly controlled. So that's a much nicer shape, I think you'll agree, than it was earlier on. Bring that back up, and we're going to try to wrap this around. Now, the problem with this, I'm going to put this in here and kind of try to take it by the white. It's just, you can't, if you stand on the edge of that path right there and look over, you really can't see anything. You can't see the hippos that are directly below you, like right in front of the white wall, if they ever want to walk up there. And that's kind of the whole point of this upstairs tiered area, is that you can see the hippos from that higher reach. So we're going to end up making that an elevated path, and it kind of hangs over the edge a little bit, and you can look down and see the hippos. Just going to do our path into the dome. Didn't want the glass to kind of just sit there like that, so we'll stick a stick in there, essentially. There you go. There's a stick. I had some real problems with grabbing things today. Everything kept disappearing behind other things. It was a bit bizarre. But anyways, just doing a little entrance panel bit there, and what are we going to do next? No idea. We're going to do the middle bit. So like I said, I want to do like... I don't want anything in the middle. Like, I don't want people walking around there. So we're going to do kind of similar to the opening dome. We're going to do like a little display in the middle, but this one's going to be coated by glass, and it's also going to be more watery based, essentially. This was also way more finicky than I expected. I couldn't merge all these groups together because it's construction items. And construction items in this game are, in my opinion, unnecessarily limited. So what I had to do was drag them all down and then separate them out into separate groups again. I actually don't think I had to do this, but this is what I ended up doing. What I wanted to do is try to group them all. I was hoping I could group my construction items, and obviously you can't, but we moved them all around a bit there, stick it in there, and then we're gonna go from each individual one, duplicate and drag down the glass to finish the whole thing off. I really hope one day they release the limitations on construction items and let us, you know, freely rotate them and stuff like that. It would really open up creativity in a real way, and it just seems like an unnecessary limitation right now. You make it an optional toggle if you don't want to confuse people. Anyways, so we've got like a glass circle in the middle. We're gonna rotate our snake, our sort of snake, our path around the middle of that. We're gonna fill it with some water. We're gonna put a tree in there. I'm going to make it into more of an elaborate feature than it looks in this. This bit is one of the major problems I'm having. It just feels messy. Now, eventually, what we're going to do is bring the... eventually, I say right now, we're going to grab that. And we're going to bring that up, and we're going to use that again. Now, the problem with this is you can really see it from everywhere else, and it kind of ruins the look of the dome atop the hill. You know, that's what I really wanted. You'll see I'm trying it there, and it looks it's okay, but it's kind of ruining my aesthetic. So eventually we'll hide it behind a little bit of a mountain. Now is fence time. I was going to go for these, but I think I decided against it pretty quickly. Oh, what am I doing? This was... God only knows. yeah, we tested out the fence. It doesn't work. So we have to go elevated a little bit there. And then, yeah, something like that. We'll be covering the side of that as well. So it's not just a gap a little bit later on. And then, of course, you can jump back in as well via there. Lovely stuff. Lovely stuff. Lovely stuff. Lovely stuff. Lovely stuff. I never know what I do. It's always in a random order. There's never any thought. It's just, what do I feel like building at this precise second in time? Oh, let's do that then. I'll get there, folks. I'll get there. Decided against this fence pretty quickly. I don't think it suits up here. You know, that's for down in the watery bits that we've got at the bottom. I did try it out, but I wasn't really happy with it. So we made a new fence. Did we do that now? Let's find out. No, we're going to the middle. This is what I mean. It's just... I'm just going to do things whenever they strike me, basically. Tried the fence out, decided against the fence because it wasn't working immediately. Oh, let's go do something else. Let's go stick a big tree in the middle. This bit definitely needs a little bit more love, but at the start, we're also going to hang some vines, some ivy, along the top of the glass, because it is meant to be moist, is really the best way to describe it. You know, it's a hippo enclosure, it's a harbour, and whilst it's pretty dry up here in general, I do want it to have that slight overgrown aesthetic, because that's really what we're pushing thematically. There's my one T word for the video in this half of the park. Shut up, world. There's my one shut up world for the video as well. this has been really... I think it was that one there. There was just this wee piece of ivy. It kept jutting out for some reason. It just wouldn't go on properly. The ivy in general is kind of a pain in the ass, but we got there. Looks perfectly nice. As long as you don't stare at it too closely, it looks lovely. There you go. Just a little chamber. I might change the tree. I think it's too big. I don't think I want it sticking out the top like that. The hippos needed some rock, so we're just going to bring some rock in around the base of the rocks. And what are we going to do now? Let's find out. It's exciting. I think it's time for just general nature. So there's going to be a lot of trees and stuff. A baobab, of course, because everyone needs a baobab. These river, what are they called again? River something trees. I can't remember what they're called. But they're little, I wondered the hedgehog. These little river trees kind of, yeah, they're pretty cool. They look like they'd be by the river. And they've got that kind of African colouring to them. They look pretty nice. So we're keeping those down only by the bank. Didn't go too hard on the trees in general. Did go pretty hard on the foliage in general, as I am wont to do. I'm not totally happy with the foliage, as you'll probably see later on in the video. That's something we'll change. I'm going to do a little inside bit here. The hippos needed shelter. Now, they actually get what I think is a fairly decent sized cave. Definitely enough for a hippo to go chill in. And they're still complaining about it, so I'm just going to leave it at this point. But they do have hard shelter. They've got a little cave, a little rest area. And what it means is now, as you can see here, we're putting this in glass. As you go past in the boat at the end, the boat's not going to be finished till, let's put it this way, a long way away. But when you go past in the boat, if the hippos are having a little snooze in there, then as you go past, you'll see them sleeping in the boat. And this is kind of the idea for the whole boat tour. I wanted to do it right now, but I have to go the other direction. The idea is you'll go through these tunnels and you'll get glimpses into the other enclosures. The boat tour itself is never necessarily going to be part of an enclosure other than with the hippo and maybe something else, but the idea is you'll get glimpses inside the enclosures. I think it's going to be really, really cool. Now for the foliage. Now for lots and lots of foliage. So that was my first stopping bit. I was losing my inspiration a little bit. I'm going to go way too hard on the elephant grass. I do sink it all down quite a lot eventually, I promise. I just like using it instead of the reeds, and it's kind of already been established as a theme at this point in time. Anyway, that's not the T word. If there's no attic, it's not the T word, okay? Loophole! So I will be sinking all that down. It just sticks out a little bit too much for my liking. I was desperate to use a topiary. It was never going to work, but I really wanted a topiary. Initially, I was staying to grassland and aquatic, because that's what the hippos like, basically. But as much as I want the animals to be super happy, they will be generally very happy. You know, the nature doesn't really affect their happiness that much. And I just want it to look good. You know, that's what we're trying to do here. We're just trying to make it look cool. So I did decide to open it back up to African, temperate, grassland, desert, and aquatic, which is the four biome selections that we're using for the whole park, basically. So I don't really plan to deviate from that much. And there we go, just sinking the elephant grass down so it looks like it's, you know, fading a little bit more naturally. And then we're going to go do something else, apparently, because I can't stop myself. Yeah, there's just going to be a lot of lining things with rocks. I'm really excited to, like, I've really enjoyed this. I think it's going to turn out well when it's done and neatened up a little bit. But I'm so excited to do something more low-key, shall we say. I'm just excited to chill with something small and a little bit more intricate, but in the small size. I'm excited about that. That's going to be cool. This has been a hell of a project. This is easily the most time I've spent on a single enclosure. I don't think it's even close. I think the wolves probably weren't that far away. They were probably 5 or 6 hours, but yeah, bloody hippo. I'm not even done yet. There's probably 2 hours work left in this, so get ready for that stream later on in the week. Anyways, again, changing the colour. Every time I looked at it, I just wanted to change it. So we go a little darker, and the darker does blend in more. And I think right now the dark colour looks better. I think some people will flat out not like that no matter what I do, but I think it looks quite cool, and it gets the look I wanted. But when we start to string more rocks around it and the fencing comes in, the white stands out really nicely. So lots of marula trees, because they make really, really good, like, dry shrubbery, which is perfect for this. Just anywhere there's grass texture on the ground, we're bringing in a little bit of that. And what else? My African daisies poking out the rocks, of course. Very much established now as a theme. In the attic of the park. No, that's not a thing. Okay, what are we doing now? Come on, stick with the plants, best and slot. Stick with the plants. I don't know why I did. I recorded this like 3 hours ago. It looks nice down there. I think the plant life, especially like when you're sinking trees into the ground, and we're doing it again here with the coastal mangrove, these are a little bit lighter than the marula, and that it creates like a, it looks like actual grass. It's varied in colour and in texture. You know, we've got three different colours there. We've got the very green of the elephant grass, we've got the quite dark unsaturated marula, and then we've got a very sort of yellowy green of this coming in. And I just think mixing and matching a few different plants together to make this sort of grass texture makes it a lot more interesting to look at, essentially. What was I saying? Hello, God only knows. I want to make like a water screen thing. I might put a waterfall at the entrance to their cave as well, so they have to walk through like this falling water. I just want stuff, I want things, I want excitement. I don't know, I'll keep coming up with ideas. I'm going to set the, yeah, trying to change the color of the tracks. It's just too yellow, it stands out quite a lot, so we're going to just make that quite a nice dark sort of brown, and that's going to blend in a little bit more with the environmental. I am tempted to as well maybe put a pattern onto the, you know, the wrapping, maybe making it in lines, kind of like the yellow and green we have on the shelter for the cable car, or also like a checker pattern, or maybe designing like a hippo in the side of it. Is that nuts? We could maybe do a hippo. Anyways, yeah. So here's my fence. It's two rock pillars and then some rope, which I quite like doing, but it works well. It suits the area really well. I think we'll end up using this on the other side of the park as well, because I think nice and simple, but it brings in the rock and it brings in the rope, two things we've used already quite extensively in this area. So yeah, lots of fence to come. I just don't like using the inbuilt fence. It just doesn't, it's okay on some of the elevated, but I think generally speaking, it just doesn't quite do the task, you know, it doesn't quite suit it well enough. And I think this ends up looking pretty cool. It looks like a zoo fence, you know, which I think is important. We're building a zoo here, or pretending to build a zoo here. Just block that off over there. There'll be some rocks there as well, don't you worry. There's gonna be rocks everywhere. Never panic. It was a little difficult to do this because you have to raise each rock individually and then tilt the rope down. The elevated paths are always a pain in the ass, so is one of the benefits of using it. So I decided we're going to fill that gap in, and we're going to use the same material once again. Now, we will actually change this up again a little bit further later on. So you see here we're using the same colour for the bit under the path and also the bit sitting at the top. What we'll actually do is change it so the bit that sits under the path is a slightly different colour, and it helps it a little bit, breaking up the monotony of the area. Planet Bloody Zoo, I love you and your hard work. It's funny, like, I lose inspiration, and then last night, girlfriend was playing on it, and she was building her park, and yeah, ended up, she's actually pretty good. But even just watching someone else play, I was like, you know what, I really want to get on, and then I get on, I'm like, oh, now I have to do this for 5 hours. And it's the thing, and it totally makes sense, it's not Planet Zoo's fault, but anytime you want to do something elaborate or just large in scale, there's going to be some time investment. It's always a little bit on the finicky side. Which is fair enough, like, how would they integrate what I've just done there, you know, this, like, modern covering, how would they integrate that into the game? They can't, really. They give you the tools to do it yourself, but it's going to be a little bit on the tedious side, you know? Anywho, this was also tedious. It'd be nice, I mean, there's little things you could do. What you could do is, let's say as an example, you'd have a fence tool, and within, like, a set length, you'd build your own fence, and then you could have a path that uses that fence automatically. I don't think that would be that difficult to code. I've played other games that do similar things. There are little things Planet Zoo could do to make the creative process easier, but by and large, it does let you do whatever you want. You just have to be prepared for some tedium in the meantime, but it's the price we pay for beauty. So, putting our fence in. I'm gonna have to bring some rocks in. Anytime there's an awkward gap, we just use rocks, basically. Changing the colors again. I actually don't mind the green that much. Decided to go for a brown. Decided to go back to white. Decided to change the white. I just can't make my mind up. I think eggshell white is where I'm leaning, because we're doing things like this. We're like snaking the rock around in these kind of natural looking but very clearly man-made areas, mainly to cover the gaps. You know, the gaps are an issue. And the rock's quite dark, especially from a view from a distance, so it looks really cool against the white. It really stands out in a contrast. As you'll see what I mean soon. Still got about 6 minutes of time lapsing left. I told you, big build, but we will be hopping into the game as well. We'll meet the hippos. You know, I can't remember their names, so we'll meet the hippos properly, and I'm sure there's more stuff we can do building wise. Anyway, gonna cover the side of this in rock, surprisingly enough. There you go. And of course we'll have to blend that in a lot better than that, because that looks a little bit silly. A little bit silly. I'm pretty sure I could have just rotated the fence with the rock and moved it down. I don't know why I didn't do that. I think I overcomplicated this for myself. Looking at it now, I definitely overcomplicated it for myself. When we come to doing the rock fence down the staircase, it's definitely could have been done easier than the way I did it. I told you there was a lot of rocks. I don't think I've ever used this many rocks in an enclosure. I don't think anybody has ever used this many rocks in an enclosure. There must be 1,000 of the bloody things. And this was my first mistake. I pay for this later on. I suffer because of this mistake. One of my rocks clicked onto the white wall, so it got added to the group. And then so did the rocks after that. And later on, when I want to change the color of the wall or just edit something else about it, it's obviously part of the group, so it needs to be extracted. And it was so annoying to do, because then I had these weird selection issues where I couldn't click on the plaster, so on the primitive shapes. So, yeah, mistakes were made. Grouping is good, but not always. Sometimes you don't want to group things that you want to change the color of in a big uniform selection. Don't want to be grouped with randomized rock pillars, basically. So, lesson learned on that one. Can't make that mistake again. I think at this point I was just happy with the white anyway, so I wasn't really bothered. Also, didn't think about it, if I'm honest. Grab all that, shovel that across to the side. There we go. We are getting there. This obviously needs some. There's another thing this area needs, is some like education boards and stuff like that. We'll do that towards the end of the video, I think. In the non-time-lapse portion. We're going to still use the same education boards, so we're just going to copy and paste those anyway. I just like them, you know? They're themed. They're well themed. How's everyone doing? Everyone good? Good. 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 Everyone's just coronaing. I'm meant to be going on holiday. My dad paid for like a family holiday for me and my dad and my sister and her 2 kids. I'm meant to be going to Turkey in like 2.5 weeks. Now, right now, that would technically be allowed. But I am not convinced that that's going to be a thing this time in 2.5 weeks. I am preparing myself for disappointment, to say the least. It's looking good, isn't it? It looks quite nice. From certain angles and distances and places, it looks pretty cool. Now, next is the entrance to the boat. Now, I don't know how much... I think the boat probably needs a roof and, like, looking a little bit... I don't know. I'm still not convinced by that. This was a massive pain in the ass, by the way. I don't know what was going on here, but the fence was just not playing nicely at all. But had to make a gap in the fence. Thankfully, the hippos can't get across here anyway, so we can leave it open. But it does need to be a null fence rather than no fence, otherwise it'll complain that, you know, it's not a valid enclosure. Now, what I wanted to do was connect the path over here, around there, about halfway down past the entrance to the cable car bit. It just wasn't working. It would not work in a million years. I don't know why it just refused. It just wouldn't latch on. So I tried everything. I tried deleting bits of path, deleting foliage in the area, deleting the fences. I got rid of the water. And it just doesn't want to do it. It just does not want to latch onto there at all. So we had to do it much further down and then bring the water back. The problem was, as you'll see in a second, I go to bring the water back and I couldn't do it. It wasn't deep enough anymore. So this is the problem with the water, really. It's very easy to get to a point where the water gets blocked off and you really have to keep checking it or you'll lose it forever. It's like, again, what happened with me on my Pen Rye build. We lost the water in the fishing village. It became really shallow because I made a mistake and I couldn't undo it. I couldn't find out what happened in the first place. Nearly there, folks. 2 minutes left. And here we go. He is taking the white bits off the rocks bit by bloody bit. Not the most fun experience I've had in my life, I'll be honest. It was finicky, to say the least. Just kind of had to remove a bit, then group it, and then remove a bit, and then group it back, and remove a bit, and group it back, and accidentally save it as a blueprint, then remove a bit, and group it back, blah, 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 blah. But did get there in the end, just about. That bit was being super weird as well. It's just been one of those days. Sometimes you hop on and everything flows really nicely, and sometimes you hop on and it's hard work. I quite like that colour, but I think the brighter works better. He was me scrambling around thinking, what the hell am I going to do? Realising that was sticking out too much, so sunk that down into the ground. Going to put like a little bit of a mountain. It looks better in a way. It needed, I think, some terrain work just to look nicer in general. The mountain's just a little bit flat. I think this is what we're going to do on the other side. Like, you look at the side there, and it's just a flat blob of sandy texture. It really doesn't look good. So we're gonna knock into it a little bit and chisel it and put some rock texture on there and some terrain tool stuff and hopefully make the whole mountain look a little bit more realistic. It should feel man-made, but it shouldn't feel man-made by committee or something. Does that make sense? Let's pretend that makes sense. How are we doing? Oh, this is the end. It looks nice, doesn't it? Yeah, going back to the eggshell white. Again, I think, I don't know. This is the point where we're nearly done. But I'll show you it in-game so you can help me decide. I think I'm going for the white. We're going to change the top, which I think helps as well. That bit sort of under the... couldn't grab that bit for some reason. Just couldn't grab it. I could grab it on its own. Completely fine. I couldn't grab it separately. I think it was in a different group. Blending that in a little bit with the path, I think, makes the whole thing look a little bit nicer. It does really have the look I was going for. I think one of the things we maybe need to do is bring some plaster into the... It's not really a dome, because it doesn't have really a dome to top, but into the circular building. I think if we integrate that white in another way, maybe the whole thing will flow a little bit nicer. Blocking off those. We do need to block off the back as well. At the moment, people could just hurl themselves off to their death, and I really don't want my zoo to be known as like a suicide hotspot, so we're going to try to undo that, hopefully. Lots of rocks. I just burnt myself out on rocks more than anything else, to be honest, folks. I placed so bloody many of them in this exhibit that I didn't want to keep doing it. It looks really nice, though. I'm happy with it, generally speaking. Is this my... Oh. A little bit more fence work. The fence isn't done either. Because, again, I burnt myself out after doing 5,000 pieces of fence. There is a benefit to using the auto fence, and it's that it doesn't take any work. Sometimes that's necessary. But yeah, there we go. I'll show you it in-game. We'll get a proper look at it. You can give me your thoughts and feelings and opinions and dreams and life wishes and loves and losses and all that kind of malarkey. I'll see you folks in a second. Right, here we go then. So let's take a look at Hippo Harbour. Still needs a little bit of love, but we're very much getting there. I think it looks really nice from certain angles. This, I'm still unconvinced by. I've made it darker, but I think we're going to, once again... Just lighten it a little bit. I think like that is quite nice. You see what I mean about the rock? It kind of like contrasts against the white quite well. And along with the brown as well. I want it to stick out. I want you to see it. I want it to look modern and sleek. But I also don't want it to dominate the perspective of the whole zoo. I don't think it does. I think it blends in quite well. I'm happy with that colour. But I would love some opinions and thoughts and feelings and blah, blah, blah. Yeah, we actually have a... I'm going to pause it. There's no... Oh, wait, what? How was that incorrectly placed? No, it's fine. What do you want about your numpty? Let's put in some of our education boards. So you can see where I put. So I'm gonna put this over here. We don't want this to stand there because that's gonna block the view of the hippos. So that's gonna go about there. I will integrate your hippo names during the live stream. So this is the idea. You can stand here and look down into the sort of the raised hippo area. The tree is blocking the view, but I actually really like the tree, so I don't think I can bring myself to get rid of it, unfortunately. So yeah, you'll stand here. Maybe we'll just move this a little bit over onto the other side. Maybe we don't put it on there at all. Maybe we have it like there. That's probably a better idea. Okay, we'll put that there. Walk along, check out. Oh wow, it's a water blob. How exciting. And you stand here and you look down and look at the water blobs. Or alternatively, when you're walking along this path, you can see, you can look down and you can see the entire enclosure from up here. Even when you're a tiny Planet Zoo human, you can see the entire enclosure and indeed the rest of the zoo, which is looking intricate, if nothing else. Right, so problems. As you can see, we have this whole massive blob of a wall right here, so that's kind of an issue. Someone has suggested, I thought it was a really good idea, to put a, if we change this direction, so this comes out a little bit down here, we can put in another station and have that connected onto this part of the giraffe enclosure, so you can go across the bridge to a little station and go up into the mountain, or indeed wrap around to this part of the park, which would actually be the case. You would go past the hippo enclosure and down here, but at least that gets you from here to here without having to walk all the way back along. And then I think we cover this side completely and hide that all away. So the mountain obviously needs a little bit of love to look less dumb. This bit needs something. I think it's just like a little hippo display and some information boards. Obviously some rocks, obviously. Just some general stuff. I'm probably going to put some more texture like this around those sides and probably over here as well. And I do want to change that tree because I think it looks like a stupid hat right now. Let's change the tree. Let's find a more appropriate tree. I want the most appropriate tree the world has ever seen. I can't use a baobab. As much as I adore the baobab, I don't think I can use another baobab already. You know, we've had enough baobabs. Africa, there we go. So what could we use? It needs to be a decent size. This would actually be perfect. I'm not going to lie. That would actually be amazing. But, you know, I don't even like that. I want one that's got a bit of a... It should feel lush, you know? Maybe that. Maybe that's an okay size. It only sticks out a little bit. And you go in and it looks okay. Need some plant life in there as well, and this whole building needs something. There's just so much to do. I don't know what to say. It's just so much work. But it is getting there. It's very gradually getting there. Then we're going to put the river in. I'm going to put in the entire river. We'll work around the river, essentially. Let me check my animal list. What are we going to do next video? What have we done? Where's our list? Hippo. We need to change the hippo. So the hippo's actually over here. To a super, super bright green, apparently. So let's change that to that. Doesn't really matter if it's not the same thing else. We'll change that at some point. Right, so we've done a little bit more of the north. We'll be moving on to the south. And like I said, I want to do something... Actually, this is pretty good for small things. We've got the aardvark. That's about it, though. What about the north? Maybe we can do another north. I just want something small. There really isn't anything. Bloody Africa. Every animal's one that feels like it requires... space, you know, but that looks cool to me. I'll give myself that. I really like how that looks, especially in motion with the water. That's pretty cool. It's pretty cool. Hippo Harbour. Right, so yeah, lots to do, but not as much as it has been. So like I said, we're gonna put some stuff over here, we're gonna block off the sides of that, we're gonna block off all this bit over here, we'll do the station, we'll extend the river. And the actual enclosure itself I'm pretty happy with. It's got a lot of texture to it, a lot of colour. Somewhere for the hippos to go inside and chill like this. Oh, that's a problem. That's an issue right there. Okay, okay, you just have to go really, don't you? Yeah. What about you? Can I get away with that one? I could put some rocks on the roof. On the upper bit to hide it a little bit, I guess. Yeah, that's, I mean, I don't mind that, actually. Let's put that sitting nestled in there. I do mind it. Looks dumb. That looks better. Okay, cool. Right, so yeah, they've got the little hippo inside bit. If we wrap around here, I'm going to put some lily pads in here as well. Something on here. Something everywhere. This is why I want to do something small. But yeah, your boat tour will eventually go through here, and as you go past, you'll be able to look up and see some sleeping hippos. This is a little bit raised and stuff, like the level is not what I would want it to be, but that's because the hippo enclosure itself is raised up. Eventually, when it... Oh my god, what is happening? Eventually, the idea is, like, you'll look to your right, you won't have to look up, and you'll be right next to the glass in the boat tour, and you'll be able to see the hippos from there. That's the hope. Let's put that rock in, shall we? And just stick another one in so it doesn't look quite so standy outy. Wait, is that going to block up the top now? No, we're fine. Okay, there we go. See? No problems. All part of the plan. So, Hippo Harbour. Ba-bum. Hippo Harbour basically finished. I would love some thoughts and suggestions. We will be back later on this week just to finalise some stuff. The path needs a bit more work. I do like that bit up there now, though. And down here as well. This bit needs a covering, maybe some poles under there so it looks like it's supported. I honestly might work on this myself, and then we might not do a stream, and maybe we'll just come back with the next video on whatever animal that may be. We shall see, but either way, we'll be back later on this week, hopefully. It is only Monday today, right? Yes, it's only Monday, so we'll be back later this week with more Planet Zoo, and if it's not the stream for this, it'll be the next enclosure, whatever that might be. It should really be something on the right-hand side. That was very much the plan, to split the park one by one by one by one by one. But we'll have a think about that. Right. Right, we're going to end it there. Thank you for joining me anyway. I'll see you lovely folks next time. Please do hit the like button if you like this video and indeed enjoy this build. Cheers, much love as always. I'm going to go sleep. Bye-bye. Hey folks, thanks for watching. If you enjoyed this video and you want to help support me a little bit more, you can do so at patreon.com/bestinslot. There's a link in the description down below. Every little really does help in times like these, but it's not at all expected, and by just watching the video you've already helped me out massively, and it makes you a pretty cool person, so well done you. Thanks for joining me either way, I'll see you next time.